Hi, my name is Bob Sherbert. I'm a graduate of Drexel University's Electrical Engineering program and one of the co-founders of Carbide Labs.
Hi, my name is RJ Gross. I'm a graduate of Drexel University. I got my Mechanical Engineering BS degree there, and I'm also a co-founder of Carbide Labs. Bob and I have a long history. We met each other at the Drexel Autonomous Systems Lab, which is located in Drexel University. So I've had a PCNC 1100 at our research lab for about 6 years now. We have a Series 2. I like to tell people that our Series 2 is just the chassis. It's actually all Series 3 guts. We've been using the machine to do various research. We build humanoid-related components and then make those components walk, which is a very cool thing.
So my favorite experience with the Drexel Robotics Lab was probably the RoboGames robotics competition. We built from scratch a miniature humanoid. We did all the mechanical and electrical design. RJ cut the whole thing on the PCNC. I did a lot of the coding work, flew the thing out there and did a foot race almost with the robots. And did very well with that.
The robot there we called Atlas. It was a tiny miniature humanoid. This is actually a leg component of a full-sized humanoid, the Hubo robot. The Hubo was designed and built originally in South Korea with permission from the Hubo lab. They allowed us to recreate the components internally within our research environment. So all the components you can see here outside of maybe the gearbox and the motors were all machined on a PCNC 1100, or at least our machine.
This now is, they've got a competition now set up similar for humanoids in which these robots are tasked to do a couple of different challenges, open up a valve, climb stairs, things like that. And that's kind of where it's at now. It's progressing pretty rapidly.
Right now, we're basically taking the platform and building it from a set of plans. But along the way, we are doing some small tweaks and things like that to make it more ours so that we can have it, say, a better sensor head for doing manipulation tasks and vision. So this project is still ongoing. I have actually a unique role. After I graduated, Drexel hired me as a full-time student. So I'm lead on building a full humanoid robot out of our machine shop.
Yeah, so Carbide Labs is a kind of a reconstitution of a bunch of guys who went through the Drexel Autonomous System Lab. What we want to do is kind of provide low-cost alternatives of some of the higher-end machines that would get used in industry for kind of the home user or the hobbyist or light industry academic type users so that they can do these things in-house, quick turn, kind of pick up the pace of the electronics fab and prototyping. Now, we're also doing a little bit of consulting work for kind of developing companies. We'll do kind of process refinement. We'll do electrical or mechanical design consulting or things of that nature, that using those kind of to bootstrap some of our other more product-focused things, which include a little TSR1 tool setter here, more focused at the manufacturing.
We started developing this tool as a partner to the hobby probe that Tormach offers. We didn't want to go too far into like high-end engineering, lots of very precisely machined components, things like that that would make it really expensive, but concentrate on the engineering topics, the tolerances, the things that really count, that really matter to make a tool setter a really good product. We focused on those, and after a few prototypes, we came out with the TSR. So we're also in the process of making a Tormach training curriculum. This curriculum is available so that they could use it to help them learn basic manufacturing, G-code, CAM, CAD, cool techniques to use the CNC machine more effectively for whatever project they're trying to do. We've gone to a few locations on people's at people's homes to help them with various tuna issues, camming issues, just general maintenance, or even how to use the machine. We can make house calls.
What do you call a guy that has no body and no nose?
Inverted pendulum?
Nobody knows.
Yeah. Oh.
Come on.
Engineer.
Wah, wah.